South Dakota State 72, North Dakota 62, the final. Eric Henderson, Hendo, for the ninth time in 12 seasons, South Dakota State is the regular season Summit League champions. Congratulations.
Thanks, Tyler. I really appreciate it. I'll tell you what, I'm so proud of our guys, our staff, just the resiliency that we've showed. It hasn't always been easy. And our guys' ability to stay with each other, and really it feels like we're about as connected as we have been all year, and I'm just so proud of them. And when you say that, 9 of 12, it just – I'll tell you what, I never take them for granted because none of them are easy, this one wasn't, that's for sure.
Won your last 4, 6 of your last 7 in the win column, which is what got you to this point. How did this team do this in the month of February?
Well, I think there's a lot of things. I think, it comes down to our players at the end of the day. Their just willingness to believe, their willingness to come together. You know, I know you remember that, you know, getting beat at the buzzer by North Dakota State, and our locker room wasn't in a great spot. But we didn't point fingers. We just, we came together. We talked about what we needed to do. And our guys just, and in particular, I mean, I don't want to point out any one guy because it's our whole group, but Charlie in particular, I will. but Charlie was just his ability to will us to victory at times. Obviously, Zeke was terrific, and Luke is Will, and Mimsy, and Kalen Moores, and who am I missing? You know,
it's Barnhart,
all those guys, and everybody on our team, honestly, has had an impact. And we've kept a positive locker room. We've kept a positive, practice floor. It's been a fun ride.
Zeke Mayo, I'm going to refer to the stats here briefly, 26 points on 10 of 18 shooting. He was 5 of 10 from 3, made his only free throw. He also had 8 rebounds, 4 assists, 4 steals. Zeke Mayo can do things that few, if anybody, in this league can do.
Yeah, he was special. I mean, he made such good plays, and I thought defensively in the second half he was really, really tough as well. We had to put him on BJ with a little more size. We ended up putting Charlie on Iheanacho. And then, offensively, he just kind of ran the show. They kept going under some of his ball screens. And that's one of his shots. If he can get a rhythm like that and get a little space, he can be nasty. And I just thought the reads that he made and just how he controlled that flow on our offensive end was terrific.
And I thought he had the play of the game late in that first half. The ball goes through easily, his hands on the rebound. They're up 6, inbounding a chance to make it 8 or 9. And he does everything. He gets the steal. He muscles the ball away from Omont, and then he takes the contact, gets an and one, and you go from maybe being down 8 or 9 to down 3 at halftime.
Well, Tyler, just right before the timeout, the under 4 timeout, they came back in and made 2 free throws, and we were down 10.
Yeah,
that was as important in the game as any. Mm-hmm. And Zeke's play there at the end, think about that. Two of the last 3 games, he kind of made the same play. Yeah. That was a big time play, but from going down 10 to going down 3 into the locker room when I didn't feel like we played very well. We talked about the more physical team was going to win that basketball game, and I felt like our physicality was really good in the second half.
And it would be easy to overlook it, but I thought Kalen Gary was superb tonight. 3 of 3 from the field, hit both of his 3-pointers, 8 points and 4 rebounds. He played 19 minutes, but it felt like every second was of value.
He was tough, and you talk about our toughness. I think it was only 6 in the first half what he played, and then so that tells you he probably played 13, 14 in the second. And we needed all of them. We went small. Excuse me, Tyler. We went small there for a little bit, which we've done at times, and so he has to guard a bigger kid, and boy, is he tough.
He shot 57% on the road against a team playing for a league championship.
That's what we said in the locker room. I mean, what a heck of a basketball game, and we took some punches from them, and they had as much to play for as we did, and to come do that at their place, it says a lot about our guys. I'm just so proud of our togetherness, and I thought we showed some toughness, especially there in the second half.
I have to ask, what was the locker room like?
We're pretty happy, I'll tell you what. Because it hasn't always been easy, as you know, Tyler. But when you go through tough times and you come out on the other side, the way they approached it, it can be a beautiful thing. And that excitement might even be just a little bit more when you have to go through some hard times. And I can't tell you how proud I am of our players and our staff and how they just continue to fight and continue to get better and better.
Coach, Congratulations. Go enjoy this.
Thanks, Tyler. I appreciate you, and thanks all those Jackrabbit fans.
Tyler Merriam with Zeke Mayo, who was superb tonight for South Dakota State as the Jacks win the ninth Summit League regular season title in the last 12 years. For starters, congratulations. And how's that sound?
Sounds amazing. You know, we've been through some ups and downs this year, obviously handled a lot of adversity. But, you know, the more connected we got throughout the season, you know, the more wins we've, you know, accomplished. And, I mean, tonight that was obviously, you know, one of the biggest factors coming out of this win is, you know, staying together. We're obviously down at half, but we fought back, fought really hard on both ends of the floor and came out with a dub.
Asked Hendo this too, but you've won four in a row, six of your last seven. What has this team done in the month of February to be able to pull this off and win a league title?
Just trusted each other. I mean, I think on both ends of the floor we were struggling a little bit, just, you know, trying to play some individual basketball. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's all about a team, and you know, coaches preach connectivity, and obviously it shows when we come out with wins like this. We feel like we're the most connected as we've ever been.
Tell me about the play at the end of the half when UND's inbounding up six, a chance to make it a three-score game, and you come up with the tip, the steal, the score, and it ends up being a three-point game at halftime.
Yeah, that's all coaching right there. I mean, they've done a great job of scouting each team that we've played, and we kind of, you know, recognized it. And, you know, I just made a headsy play and went after the ball. I knew he was going to lob it up there, so I went after it and made a play.
What did it mean to you to have the ball in your hands dribbling out the final few seconds?
It meant everything. I mean, you know, I came back to this school just to show that, you know, we aren't done. We had unfinished business last year, and, you know, we're gonna reach for that again this year. We obviously have some momentum going into Sioux Falls, but we know we've got a tough schedule no matter who we're playing. So, I mean, it's obviously a great feeling just to, you know, be here and be present winning this championship.
Your coach talks so much about connectivity. What has that meant to you guys?
Everything. We've got a circle that we preach on, you know, before every game, before every practice. And, you know, early on we kind of struggled a little bit, like I said. But, you know, here down the stretch, obviously we're in our six of our last seven. I think it's shown the most. And when you have connectivity on both ends of the floor, you get wins like this one.
I have to ask, we talk so much about the Easleys and the Mimses and the Apples and the Mayos. How special was Kalen Gary tonight?
Amazing. I mean, he's one of those guys that, you know, he doesn't, you know, fill up the stat sheet with, you know, stats, but he does the little things on the floor that, you know, make a difference in the game and make a big impact on both ends. He's a great defender, very, very physical, and he's a guy that we needed to, you know, step up and be one of those, you know, glue guys and carry out that toughness for us on the defensive end especially. But he's shown up night in and night out, you know, and you know, done his job, and he's doing fantastic.
How much fun was that locker room a few moments ago?
It was incredible. Great atmosphere, you know, water splashing everywhere. It just feels good just to be in this situation, in this moment, knowing everything that we've been through all year long. It feels amazing.
And Zeke, lastly, tonight with 26 points, now 1,496. You're one of the top nine scorers now in South Dakota State men's basketball history.
It's a blessing, you know, just understanding the history that this team has, the players that have gone through here. It just feels so surreal, especially doing it in just 3 years. I mean, it's amazing, but, you know, the guys around me trust me, my coaches trust me. But, I mean, I've put in a lot of work to be in this position, so I'm just very, very thankful and blessed.
Zeke, congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.